Okay, good evening all. Today also we are going to discuss latest September to December topics along with follow-ups. And I'm going to share the screen with you all. The first topic is describe a time when you were not allowed to use your phone. Who is going to speak on this topic? Yes. Sravya, you can start.
Well, in this contemporary world, mobile phones have been part and parcel of our life. So more than luxurious things, it is necessary to have a mobile phone. So today I would like to discuss about a time which were not allowed to use my mobile phone. Mostly I would use my mobile phone in the bank. So at the banks I can't able to use my mobile because it's a in the banks almost everyone are busy in their works. So if I do clicking pictures of my mobile phone, then anyone can take my cash and do any theft. So I better not to use that mobile phone, because when I was in a queue on the bank, so I was busy with the Xerox papers what I have taken and the forms when I was going to the bank, I went to fill a bank debit card. So at the time I was very busy with my mobile phone. So with my documents, I was very busy with my documents, what to submit and what are the documents that I have to submit it. So at that time when someone calls me, so I did not lift the call, and it's not the good time to lift the call, answer the call. So at that time I
was are confusing between you did not use and you were not allowed.
Yeah.
Or you could not. You are using cannot. You should say I could not.
The thing is,
you were not allowed. It is not you could not use.
Okay.
Harsh, what do you want to say? You have raised the hand.
Yes, ma'am. Well, mobile phone plays a crucial role in every individual's life. We cannot imagine our life without mobile phones. Today here I would like to talk about a time when I was unable to use my mobile phone. I remember couple of years back, I went to the Golden Temple at Amritsar with my Kithan teams, because it is really a beautiful place as well as religious place. I remember when I was doing ritual ceremonies in the premises of temple, out of blue, my phone started rang up and I opened my mobile phone. After that, I switched off mobile phone. To be honest, all the individuals who did their ritual ceremonies in the premises of temple were disturbed because of my mistake. And apart from this, one of my friends scolded me about this mistake because mobile phones are not allowed to the premises of temple as well as it is really mentioned in the notice board. After that, when I came back from the temple, I switched on my mobile phone. When I came back from the temple, I checked my mobile phone. After that, this call was by my bosom, my friend. He told me to something about my exam because the date of my exams are near, and he told me about the important topics about the mathematics. Apart from this, I felt very awkward after that incident.
You felt
awkward.
Awkward. Reason?
Because I felt shy when all the individuals looked at me.
I didn't get your last point. Why you felt awkward?
Well, I felt awkward because all the individuals looked at me in the temple when my phone started ringing up.
Okay, when your phone started ringing, and I think, I don't know in which PDF this answer is, many students are saying this, see, you could not use and you were not allowed. But still you took it because you did not follow the rules. When it started ringing, because you forgot to switch it off. Is it like that?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then it is relatable. Sravya, you have to be careful. Like, you were not allowed. It's not, you could not use you due to some reason. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Okay, ma'am.
All right, guys. Let's discuss this topic. Okay. In what kind of places or situation should mobile phones be banned?
I think, can I speak?
Yes, anybody.
I think mobile phones should be banned in religious places and as well as in offices, because mobile phones distract us a lot and it becomes difficult for us to concentrate on our work. So I think the uses of a mobile phone should be banned in offices, in office hours from 8 to 5 p.m.
Any better answer?
I would say that when any kind of riots are going, I think phone should not be used in those places. Some places like library, religious places like temple, churches and mosque, because people are doing some other kind of activities or they're concentrating in their prayers. So ringing phones or anybody calling over the phone, talking over the phone can make a kind of distractions.
Okay, how has the use of cell phones impacted on our daily life? Or our everyday lives?
Well, according to me, I would say that the uses of cell phones are increasing day by day because people totally depend on technology in their profession and their personal lives. So it has greatly impact on our daily lives because everything, online activity has been done in the cell phones only. So people are more reliable on the cell phones rather than the past.
Same question, Agnesh. How has the use of cell phones impacted our everyday life?
Well, mobile phone impacted our life in both positive as well as pessimistic ways. In positive ways, with the help of mobile phone, we can easily conversate with other individuals who are far away from my house, as well as we can easily know about the every information with the help of internet. If I talk about pessimistic way, it can distract our when we are studying, for instance. I remember last Sunday I study about math, and that time I checked my Instagram and I scroll around 1 hour and it distracts my concentration.
Okay. Sravya, what do young people use the most on mobile phone these days?
Vedaranka, many people will not sit on the computer, so mobile phones will be handy, and most of the people use mobile phones on the WhatsApp chatting and group messaging and YouTube. They can spend some more time on the YouTube, and they can go to Google and know more information about the new things and about the latest news and latest updates around the world.
Agnesh, what do young people use the most on mobile phone these days? Manpreet?
Mostly people use mobile phone for WhatsApp, Facebook, Instagram. And if I talk about myself, I generally use it for seeing videos on YouTube, because suppose if we are student, then we use YouTube for in-depth knowledge of topics, because there are a lot of information available on YouTube, and that is free of cost. So I think mostly people use it for YouTube and social media apps.
Okay, how do you compare life without a phone and now? Yes, Nancy.
I would say, like, without a phone is could be a sea without a water nowadays, because we are largely dependent on mobile phone for everything, that whether we are doing, want to do an online shopping, whether we want to order a food. So especially during the pandemic time, mobile phone become a great company for people who were sitting at home, and because it also offered a lots of opportunity to do online services or online business or online work, so it became a very, like, it was very handful or helpful technology, I can say.
Anybody else, same question? How do you compare life without a phone and now?
Well, according to me, I would say that yes, there is a compare between without a phone, we can't stay because people are totally depend on the phone. The reason is that they have to do so many things, like especially if they want to contact with their family, if they want to build a personal relationship or want to make an emergency call, so they have to utilize a phone. On the other side, by the professional way, if they want to develop the business or they want to deal with any kind of business deals, so they have to talk over the phone. So I think totally life is totally took a backseat from there. They are out of their own world and they totally depend over the phone.
Should children be encouraged to use mobile phones from a young age? If yes, why? If no, why not? Yeah, Harsh.
Well, according to my own experience, children should not be allowed to use the mobile phone in their early age because in their early age, they do not about what is right and what is wrong. They do different kinds of things with the help of mobile phone. For instance, they play different kinds of game in mobile phone because nowadays it is because nowadays children can easily download any game with the blink of an eye, as well as they watch different kinds of illegal images as well as videos. So that's why I do not think children should be encouraged to use mobile phone in their early age.
Okay, same question, Gurdas. Should children be encouraged to use mobile phones from a young age? Nancy?
I will definitely not suggest any younger children to use a mobile phone at a very early age because somewhere I feel that they might distract them, and if they get in touch or get very comfortable and cozy with the mobile phone, they most of the time they would like to spend on the mobile phone and wasting their study times. At the same time, if they get a taste of video games, then they will avoid to go outdoor games for outdoor activities, and they prefer to become a couch potato at the same time.
Okay, let's move to next topic. Describe an outdoor market that you have visited or you have visited. Where is it? What did you buy from there? What did you like about that place? Explain how was the experience. It's like street market, guys. Describe a street market or describe an outdoor market that you have visited. Where is it? What did you buy? And what did you like about that place and how was the experience? Who is going to speak on this topic? Yes.
I will.
Ma'am, may I speak? Okay.
Anybody?
Today I would like to discuss about the outdoor activity. No,
we can never start because in exam we are going only for one day. So we never say today I'm going to. Simply say, okay. Give a description of market, then talk about an outdoor market.
I would like to tell about the outdoor market which I visited numerous times because of my grocery, home grocery. So during this pandemic issue, so we have a schedule for the to buy the grocery. So it is near to the vicinity of from my home. So it's hardly 1 kilometers far away from my home. So during that time, so I bought a numerous things like the vegetables. I bought the vegetable, though I don't have I have a very awful experience for that. I didn't have much knowledge. So it's a rudimentary concept when you buy something. So you should have a proper knowledge from your parents. So during that time, I have some few knowledge from my parents. And based on that, I went to the market to buy the vegetables, and also I bought some electronic gadgets to utilize at my home. So that place is very crowded, and people are coming from the different city and different city because that market is very famous, and it is very incredible market. It is very incredible market. So all of the people are coming because there are the place is very spick and span, and the service provided by the market is very it has a very great impact on people, and they also buy the fresh thing. So it was a very great experience for me because I never had such experience before that. Neither I have the good knowledge how to buy something. So I think I went to the outdoor market and visited numerous times, and that really has a grateful experience for me.
Okay, you used incredible word, means in the context of extremely good. That can go, but just tell me why you use everywhere the word rudimentary. What is the meaning of rudimentary?
It's a basic knowledge, man.
Very basic. So yes. Why you used it in the market one?
Rudimentary means I'm going to say that it's a very basic knowledge when you have a experience or knowledge
so
about
that. I know the meaning. I just want to say in every topic you use this word, are you aware about the meaning?
Yes, ma'am, I'm aware
about it. Yeah, you are. It's a basic knowledge. We call it rudimentary.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Anybody else? Same topic? One girl was willing.
Yes, I want to speak.
Yes.
I love shopping, and last week I came to know that my relatives are coming to my house. Then I, while cleaning my house, I realized that the curtains of my drawing room are not in good condition. So I had no time to go to mall, and then I decided to do shopping in outdoor market. And post purchase, although I was not happy because my parents were saying that these curtains are of inferior quality, and they were not happy with this purchase. And also they told me that these curtains can shrink after one washing. But when my relative came to my house, they started admiring the curtains. They were saying that these curtains are looking so good. And then I was satisfied because they like it. And when I wash them first time, they were not shrunk. So this was the time when I went to outdoor market for buying something, and I was really very happy to after purchasing these curtains.
Okay, you said after one washing, it could be after one wash. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, it's better to talk about market more rather than only product. Okay.
Okay.
Yes, you can talk about the product. First, tell about the detail. What kind of market is, what kind of products are available, then how you searched for the proper curtains, then you like went for the bargaining. So everything you must add, okay?
Okay.
Not only the purchase you have to talk about, you can talk about so many things. All right, guys, let's discuss this topic. Is open market or street market or outdoor market a popular concept still? Yes, Harsh.
Yes, definitely. It is a very popular concept in today's life because majority of individuals in my nation are not an handsome amount of salary. So that's why they prefer to purchase different kinds of items, food items, as well as beverage from the local market because they provide different kinds of items at a pocket friendly price, as well as these items are not in the, as well as the item, the quality of these items are not good, but without any reason majority of individuals purchase these kinds of items due to financial crisis.
Okay, not bad at all. Yes, Baldeep. Is open market a popular concept still?
Yes, ma'am.
My question is this one. Is open market or outdoor market a popular concept still? Like, see, nowadays we have malls, okay? Big stores. So this is the question related to that. That still these markets exist. So we are saying, yes, of course, these exist. And why? Yes, Baldi, Nancy, anybody?
Yes, ma'am. I will say yes, definitely the concept of street market or outdoor market is still popular even now. It's because it really offers lots of offers even for the destitute people or the middle class people who cannot afford to buy in the shopping malls, because sometimes shopping malls, they really sell some imported products and which is not like reachable to all the people. So I will say it is, and at the same time, these outdoor markets also offers an employment for the people who cannot afford to go to the office, and means they cannot afford to get a good job, so they still can have a small business in the street market and earn their wages.
Okay, how do you think the idea of shopping or going to markets are changing nowadays?
The idea of changing shopping or going to the market is changing because of the online shoppings. Nowadays, people love to stay in their own comfort zone and wants to buy on sites. And especially during the pandemic situation, it became really very affordable or easy and convenience for the people to do online shoppings, and instead of stepping out of the house to go for a shopping outside.
What kind of things people in your country often buy from online shops? Yes, Baldi. What kinds of things people in your country often buy from online shops?
People of my country prefer to buy trendy clothes, shoes, and many of the accessories from online, as they find it difficult to go in the street market and waste time in selecting different type of clothes. Rather than that, they prefer to shop online.
Yes, and mostly what kind of product they buy? Shoes, this clothes, jewelry, and you can say accessories also. So you can talk about number of things. And these days people are buying gadgets, electronic gadgets.
Yes.
What are the reasons of popularity of online shop?
There are many reasons of popularity of online shopping, because it is convenient for the people. There are high collection and variety of products and no sales pressure in online marketing. So it's discount will be available, and sometimes coupons also will be available. And at the time of festivals, there will be a lot of discount when compared to shopping malls.
What are the reasons for popularity of online shopping, Harsh? What are the reasons for the popularity of online shopping, guys? You can talk about today's situation as well. Yes, Nancy. Amardeep, yes. Where are you?
Yes, ma'am. I would say that yes, definitely.
So then speak, guys. What are the reasons for the popularity of online shopping?
Well, there are many reasons for popularity of online shopping. First and foremost, in nowadays, most of the individuals are busy in their hectic schedule, so they purchase different kinds of items from the e-site such as Amazon and Flipkart, because it saves their a lot of time. Apart from this, secondly, this site gave us massive discount on the special occasions such as New Year, Diwali, and other kind of traditional festival. Last but not least, the price and the quality of products which are sold by these sites are very good, as well as we can easily return our products if they are not good.
What are the possible disadvantages of buying online, Nancy?
The most important disadvantage can be the people is unable to identify or check the quality of the product. And sometimes the size also varies, because the size they show sometimes is not matching. Like if I take example, once it happened with me also, that during my cousin's wedding, I ordered the shoes and I gave the perfect size. But when it got delivered, I found that the shoe was bigger than my size. So I have to return it back, but I could not wear that shoes because I wanted to wear it on the wedding. So I have to go to the market again to buy a separate pair of shoes for that reason. So sometimes it becomes a little late also to return it back and get it back.
Okay. Guys, reasons for the popularity are, of course, everything is available.
Ma'am, sometimes
variety is available, discounts are available. easily, you can say, delivered at our home. Fine variety on one click, you can see many colors. Even you can check how, like, what kind of reviews it has.
Yes,
Ravya, you wanted to say something?
Sometimes by buying on online shopping also, frauds will be also be available.
Yeah, in disadvantages, of course.
Yeah.
The things you order, sometimes you get something else, then you return. Sometimes there is no refund policy, sometimes fraud can be there. And sometimes what happens, like, it does not get delivered at the same time. For example, it is birthday tomorrow, and the gift is, you know, going to be delivered next week. There is a delay also sometimes.
Yes.
So there are so many reasons. And secondly, the most important reason, you cannot touch, you cannot check, you cannot try the products. Sometimes, of course, they have models. It looks so great on model. And when you wear, you think that it's waste of money. Then you end up returning. It's sheer waste of time. Why do you think people buy things that they hardly use? Yes, Amardeep, Baldeep.
Whenever people find some of the discount offers on particular things, they often buy that thing rather than thinking that the use of that thing will come in their future or not.
Okay. Yes, Nancy.
I feel in order to show their possessions that what they can afford to buy, and maybe to follow some trends, or sometimes they want to follow their friends as well, and they get somewhere inspired, and they don't bother about whether they can hardly use it or not, or whether they can know how to use it or not.
Yes. Why do people buy things that they hardly use? Because they get discount, they get lured by the, you can say, offers. Sometimes salesmen convince them, okay? Salesmen convince them, and sometimes due to advertisements, they feel that this thing should be there. And like Nancy said, just to show the possession, sometimes people buy things which they hardly, or maybe they don't use at all, just to show that we have this at home, okay? All right, guys, next latest topic is describe a talent you have and want to improve. It can be describe a natural talent you have and you want to improve. For example, you're good at singing, you want to learn it. You're good at sports, you want to improve it. Okay, you are good at painting, you want to improve it. You want to take training. So any talent can be there. Yes. Who wants to speak on this topic? Describe a natural talent you have, you want to improve. Yes?
I will tell about this.
Okay.
Okay, natural talent is a very imperative role for every human life. So I believe that I am one of them. So I do have the natural talent about the soccer. So I want to improve in that, because I played well in that, and I know how to kick the ball because I'm very good and good in terms of running and in terms of my stamina. So during my coaches also, they tell that you have a very great talents to how to kick the ball and secure the goals. So even though I tackle the situation, difficult situation, I move around, and anyhow I can chase the ball and I can kick the ball very hardly. So during the numerous matches, I achieved a good goals while playing the soccer. So even though I have a good stamina and can beat the best, if I do get proper trainings and improve an improvement while playing. So I would say that I have the advantage because it will in future, if I do get a proper training, definitely I will play to the national level or international level. So it will it has a benefit to my life. So definitely I would say that I have the natural talent if I do get a proper coaches from my seniors or from any institute. So definitely, I would say that only I just want to improve the talent from my improve the talent with my proper experience.
Okay, one more person, same topic.
Okay, ma'am, I say every person possesses a natural talent which needs to be identified and nurtured with the passage of time. And I feel that I am lucky that I got to know about my talent at an early age, and I believe that I am good at it. And I never got a chance, or I never admitted myself to a proper training schools, but somewhere I got a chance to learn. I got a chance to learn from my father's, and he was very good in art and craft. So somewhere I also developed this interest in art and craft, observing my father. I used to observe my father that how he used to decorate the house on my birthdays and Christmas and other occasions by making decorative things by himself. So during my school days also, I used to take parts in many drawing competitions, and it was quite lucrative because I used to win prizes and help me to enhance my ability to the next level. And I really want to improve this this talent as well, so that in the future I can make more lucrative things, so that I am and also it will help me to get relief from my stresses and worries. And sometimes I feel that the best way to get relief of the monotonous life, if somebody can get indulged in making more innovative things by art and crafts or kind of embroideries, anything. And it also helps you to utilize the things that wastage things in the house, means you can and also practice the activity of recycling things from the old all thrown out things as well. And if I get a chance, then in the future I would like to open a side business, because I have also seen many people do small business by selling handmade crafts. So I would also like to have a small shop where I would like to sell my handcrafts nest, so that people can buy them and they can enhance the look of their house.
Very nice. Okay, let's discuss this topic. Do you think talented people are happy people as well? If yes, why? If no, why not? Anybody, guys, all participants.
I will say yes, talented people are happy people because they have lots of things in their mind, and their mind is always active, and they are not stuck with one thing. They're always thinking out of the box to create new things.
Yes, anybody else? So you all agree that
me,
talented people are happy also?
Yes, definitely. I would say that there are people who are very health conscious and want to deliver his or her talent in terms of sports or in terms of any craft activity. So according to me, for instance, if I take the example of great cricketer Sachin Tendulkar, so he is very fascinated about his game, and he indulged deeply and have and deliver the profound result while playing the cricket. So definitely somewhere it has a great impact. People who are talented and they are more happy and precarious about their sports.
They are okay. Happy about their sports or their talent?
About
in general, Harsh, do you think talented people are happy people as well?
Well, according to my perspective, talented people are not happy at all the time, because happiness is not depend on the talent. It is totally depend on the individual. For instance, if any individual do any kind of thing and it makes me happy, then he feel happy. But it is not totally depend on the talent, because most of the talented people are not happy in today's world. For instance, a famous celebrity.
Okay, guys, see, talent and happiness, yes, they can. It depends. You can give the answer in yes as well or no also. Yes, why? Like Amardeep said, like Sajit, even he gave example also. That's good. It's good to give example in part three. So like Sajit, he's happy about his, we have always seen him happy, not only about achievement, about playing the game. Yes. If somebody is painting, they are happy in their art. Somebody's writing, they're happy about writing. But like Harsh said, yes, happiness can be like it's a inner feeling. Sometimes people are very talented, but they are not happy. Because it's a state of mind, whether they are happy or not. Some people are very talented, they are good at writing. They don't get right opportunity, they are not very happy with their life. So the answer can be in both way. Both are correct.
Okay.
How do you differentiate between talent and skill? Good question.
There are a lot of differences between the talent and the skill. So talent means whether it will be an inborn ability, and it is a special ability of a person to do something. So for example, if a person is a music, is very interested in music, and if family ancestors also they are in of the same family, then that is obviously their children will be also very talented, and they can be keeping more interest on the music. And skill is an ability to put on your time and effort to develop. So how we develop our skills, I mean interpersonal skills, behavior skills, how we develop our skills is related to about the skill.
Yes, anybody else?
Yes, I would say talent can be in birth or is a natural talent, or I would say talent can be in birth or it can be a God gifted, and a person can move a lot, can move forward with the talent as well, and they can enhance the talent every day. And skill, on the other hand, a person can get skillful through his experiences and by doing lots of practices. So skill is achieved like that. So a talented person can also become a very skillful person if the person keeps on practicing.
We generally say natural ability, we call it talent, and skill that we can learn,
develop,
but we can improve our talent as well. Okay. Nice, good question it is. What are the talents you have that you are proud of? Everybody will answer this because this question is related to everyone. What are the talents or talents that you are proud of?
I would say that I'm an amiable person, and people say that I have the capability to adjust in any situations. Even I feel that I have a talent to adopt or learn anything very fast. And I have the capability.
Okay, nice, to very nice. Any other talent? Yes, Baldeep, Sravya, Harsh, everybody will tell. What are the talents that you are proud of?
Well, I have a lot of talents, but most of the time, I always feel proud of my talent of being creative. I love to make new things from the waste material, like waste paper.
Okay, good, nice. Harsh?
My talent.
Yeah, Harsh, tell me about your talent.
Well, I have abundant of talent, but the most important talent which I am proud of me, and it is the talent of patience, because I'm very patient person, and I cannot easily lose my temper. Whenever I talk with other individual who are very hyper, I can easily listen their things as well as after that I take any decision. So that's why I think I have patient person, and it is my natural talent.
Okay, Sravya.
There are a lot of talents in me. I definitely listen to music. So I'm very fond of listening to music. And
no, that is not a talent.
No, I'm very much interested. I will sing songs also. So that will be a talent.
Listen to.
Okay.
Talent could be like you have something related to music. Okay. You know how to, you can say, play the
guitar,
to sing something like that.
Okay. So
listening to music is not talent. Singing can be.
Yeah, there are a lot of talents in me. So the most is the foremost is the singing music, and self management and managerial skills.
Okay, that's a natural. You have these talents and you are proud.
Yeah.
Okay, fine. Yeah. Yes, others, Manpreet and Amardeep, your talents. We are waiting.
I think I'm good at cooking and as well as creativity. Beside this, I think I learn the things easily. I'm proud of my skills because of cooking, I can cook food for myself, and because of creativity, I can I can do something in my something for myself in free time, and even I can make I can start a small business based on that. So I'm proud of these talent.
Okay. Yes, Amardeep.
Well, according to me, I'm very good in account because I'm very good in financial. I'm very passionate about that because I'm very proud of because I can utilize my basic sense in that. So even though it's very difficult, especially for the tally and especially for the final account, so I can make it possible in 1 hour. So I would say that I'm very good in accountant in financial term.
Okay. Next question is I think I have asked everyone.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Next question is related to that. How have these talents helped you to achieve what you have right now? I think Amardeep is in the same field.
Yes, definitely. I would say that I achieved the financial criteria because, as I said, that I'm very good in to prepare and maintain the balance sheet. So during the final accounts, I can explore my talents in financial analytical as well as into others' account. So in my experience, so I got a good job opportunities to work with the finance industry because of my talents in account. So definitely somewhere it got hit very greatly that I got a good post and good designations due to my great talents in account.
Okay, how important are those talents for you as an individual?
Well, according to me, yeah, it's very very imperative and vital role for me because that talent, as far as for individual, it enhanced my skills and knowledge, and based on that, I got the opportunities in the market and to work in the finance industry. So I would say that talent is very crucial in especially in my life.
Yeah, like Nancy, you were saying, you have talent of learning new thing.
Yes.
So how important are those talents for you as an individual?
I would say since I have the ability to learn anything very easily. So whenever I have given any tasks, I can finish it on time or without spending effortlessly. And I don't have to spend too much of time to finish that work.
Previous question was related to have you achieved something because of those talents related to your profession, something. Next is as an individual. So you can say by learning new things, I am improving myself. Yes. I am becoming a better individual. Okay. So guys, this last question is related to individual. You as a person, how you are improving, how you are becoming a better individual as an individual, better person. Hum kehte nahi ke I was I am a better person as compared to a few years back.
Yes. Means I became more independent.
Use this for ourselves. Why? Because now we are more patient. Now we are more humble. Earlier we were short-tempered. So we have learned with age. We have learned with experience. Okay? We have. And those talents for you, if you have talent of, for example, Harsh said, I have talent. I am naturally, I am very patient person. So he can say patience. If a person has patience, of course, it makes you better individual as compared to those who do not have. Okay. All right, guys. Next topic is describe a recent piece of news you read. Any news? When was it? What was it about? How did you get the news? And how did you feel when you got the news? Yes.
Okay. As we know that nowadays, newspaper is always covered with news. Even in the television, whenever we switch on something new or the other, news is coming up. So today, here I would like to talk about a news that I read in a local newspaper. It is about the new park that is coming up in my locality. At the in the morning, when I got the chance to read the newspaper, I was definitely very jubilant to hear that that the municipality of my locality is planning to make a new a small park for the older people, even for the younger children. So it was a great opportunity for the elderly people to go out and hang around, even for the morning walk and or evening walk. And it was also a good opportunity. I felt that it will also give a good opportunity for the younger children, thus who are spending most of the time sitting in the house because of the pandemic situation, playing the video games or the games on the desktop. So they will get a chance to play outdoor games and become more active in that if they are suffering with obesity. So it was a great news, and everyone in the community felt very happy, and they were eagerly waiting for the constructions of the park so that we all can enjoy and we can socialize with the local people at the same time, because we were all stuck in the house. And I definitely also feel very happy, and I feel more happy for my mother as she is a diabetic patient. So I will get a chance to take her out for a morning walk as well as the evening walk so that she can get little relief and get subsided from all these problems that she is facing due to diabetes. And sitting at home for 2 years, even I have put on lots of weight. So somewhere I feel also I will get a chance to lose some of the weight, and at the same time to get a chance to meet the other people and get more socialized, and my communication skill will also improve. So it was a
it was good, very good. Yes, who else?
Well, I would tell about the recently piece of news I heard in the televisions and also in the newspaper. As it is very a dormant situation, and day by day the number of patients has increasing due to the pandemic issues. So the COVID has a badly impact to our environment, and it exacerbates the people life day by day. Has the condition is getting deteriorate because of the unavailable of medicines, and no bed sheets are available to the patients, especially to the town side like Mumbai cities. So I heard the news that even though the people who take the vaccines, who took the vaccines, they are also challenging, facing the certain kind of illness due to the duplicate vaccines. So I heard this in the ideally read the newspapers, because the situation is getting worse. So on the other side, I also heard the news that people are losing their jobs, and they don't have the they are facing the issues in terms of financial stability and financial crisis, as the economic is getting day by day down because of this pandemic issues. So people are also losing their jobs, and they also lose their loved one because they don't have the proper availability of, or we can say proper proper availability of medicines. So the poverty growth is getting high, and the youngsters are losing their jobs due to the pandemic issues. So on the finally, I heard from last 2-3 days recently that the COVID regular the COVID disease are getting down, and government regulate the disease, and people and the patients are also getting cure because of the some medicine facilities available in the market. So I felt very much happy, pretty happy when I heard this newspaper. So it is overwhelmingly regulate the control of patients, and people are coming out of from their home, and they are probably begins the work as far as they do from their past or from their past.
Okay, let's discuss this topic. Here in this topic, guys, you can talk about it was not only local news, any news you can talk about, news related to good news related to Olympic, Paralympics. Okay, and you can talk about local news as well, international news like Afghanistan as well, because it's not a good news only. Okay, part three, how do people in your country get everyday news? I want Sravya, Manpreet and Harsh and Baldeep, four of you to answer these. You all are not speaking. How do people in your country get everyday news?
Well, individuals of my news get news for, well, individuals from my nation get news from many ways. First and foremost, they get news from the newspapers. Apart from this, younger generation of my nation get the news from mobile phone, because with the help of internet, they can easily get the information and news about what happenings in all over the world.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Well, there are a lot of medium through which people of my nation get everyday news, like newspaper, as every person enjoys reading paper, which interacts them with various events happening around them. Moreover, people also get news through online, on internet, as well as on televisions, as large population love to watch things visually rather than reading. So these are the mediums through which people of my country get everyday news.
Yes, from newspaper to television to radio and social media. Okay, have news channels and media become more effective in spreading news these days?
Yes, definitely. I think news channels and the media is playing a major role in nowadays, because they will be spreading news to the remote areas and the rural areas also. For example, when Modi announced when it's a lockdown on 2019, then everyone will don't know about the information with the help of the televisions and the media, so everyone can know the news and everyone can be aware of it.
Yeah, more effective, because see, the newspaper will reach next day.
Yeah, next day.
And
yeah,
news channel and media, they can spread it live.
Yeah,
you can say fire in a minute, in a second. Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you think technology has helped us to be updated with events across the globe, Harsh?
Well, technology plays a crucial role in every individual's life. With the help of technology, we can easily know about what happenings in all over the world. For instance, with the help of internet, we can easily know about what the temperature in Canada and what the temperature in USA. Apart from this, we know about what kind of festivals.
Yes. Harsh, you got mute. Of course, technology has helped us, because we get every news or every information within seconds. And yes, like you were saying, we are aware about international festivals, international events as well, because of this technology. Okay, next question is, should students be encouraged to read the news every day? If yes, why? If no, why not? Manpreet.
Yes, definitely they must be encouraged, because by reading news every day, their reading and writing skills improve, and also they can enhance their vocabulary, which can further help them in getting good jobs in future.
And also in IELTS. Generally, people say we should read, you know?
Yeah.
Okay, same question, Harsh. Should students be encouraged to read the news every day?
Well, according to my own experience, learners should be encouraged to read the news in their daily basis, because when they read different kinds of news which are available on the internet as well as newspaper, then they know about what happenings in all over the world. For instance, if they read about the news which are related to crime, they know about what effects of crime after the what kinds of crimes are popular in their country. Apart from this, they know about what kinds of things are happened all over the world,
are happening around. Fine. Okay. Are news apps commonly used by young people in your country? Why and why not?
I don't think that young people are using news app, because they are most interested in social media apps. They have Facebook, Instagram on their phone, but they hardly install news apps from Play Store. So I don't think they have news app.
Okay. Anybody else?
I would say yes, to some extent, these news app are being installed by the young people because sometimes they are very busy with their schedules, and sometimes they have to walk to their college or to their workplace. So during the short period of time, if they don't have a time to read the newspapers or look into the television, they can easily open their phone and they can go through the recent news that are happening around.
Okay, the answer can be in both ways, guys. Okay. Some people are using these apps only because they are not reading newspaper, they are not watching TV, they don't have time. So they have an application and they open it and they come to know what is happening. Okay. So this way also you can say. Otherwise, if you are saying no, they are least interested in news these days. So you can say as a youngster, you can say, like Manpreet said, even I don't read, she can give her example. Na?
Mm-hmm.
Even I don't have time to read news. So I am, if something, these days on social media platforms like Instagram and Facebook also, you get updates about news. If you like a page related to a news channel. So this is the reason youngster hardly download app.
Yes.
तो अगला कहता है कि ऐप क्यों हम अपने इंस्टॉल करें व्हेन वी गेट द न्यूज
थ्रू
सोशल मीडिया सी ऑन इंस्टा लाइक राइट नाउ अगर वैसे वी शुड नॉट से समथिंग हैपेंस इन दिल्ली इवन इफ वी आर ओपनिंग आवर इंस्टाग्राम और फेसबुक वी विल गेट द न्यूज इन पीपल्स फीड्स पीपल आर शेयरिंग दैट सो इन दीज डेज सो देयर इज नो नीड ऑफ एप्लीकेशन और गूगल Or we get news through our social media application. Twitter pe to it is trending. Today, what is trending on Twitter? Those are the latest news. Okay. Anyway, any type of answer can be given because they are checking your English. Next answer, Baldeep and Harsh. Do you think printed news is more reliable than e-news? If yes, why? If no, why not?
Ma'am, can I try? Like, I would say printed news are more reliable because we come to know the source from where the news is coming. On the other hand, this electronic news is little uncertain because anybody can spread any kind of rumors or unpredictable news. So definitely, I would suggest that printed news are more reliable and trustworthy.
Yes, you can say source. Because on e-news, we cannot trust on all the sources.
Yes.
Sometimes, you can give example. There are so many rumors of, you can say, about celebrities.
Yes.
Fine. Shah Rukh Khan is no more. Earlier, they used to say like, Dilip Kumar is no more. Well, I think last month it was like, Nasiruddin Shah. And he himself declared that I am alive. Okay, so e-news. So generally it starts trending that person is no more because whatever is the source, people keeps on sharing. They don't check.
Yes.
But of course, printed, it is Times of India. They have to take responsibility.
Yes.
If they are publishing such kind of vague news.
They know the yes. protocol.
Okay, last question, Harsh, for the day. Do you think newspapers would be completely replaced in the future? If yes, why? If no, why not? I want two answers for that. Yes also, no also. Yes, Harsh.
Well, according to my own experience, newspaper will not be completely replaced in the forthcoming future because newspaper is very crucial for every individual in my nation. According to survey conducted by the Tribune, nearly 70% of individuals in my nation prefer to read the newspaper in the morning time as well as they know about what the happenings in all over the world. Apart from this, newspaper is very crucial because they are very genuine as well as the news which in newspaper is very reliable as well as these news is come from the trustworthy sources.
Okay, anybody else? Anybody, guys? Last person.
I would say that newspaper can be get replaced in the future as people are working more hard to reduce the cutting down of the trees as because of deforestations that are taking place. So maybe in the future, the government will focus more on different kind of apps so that the paper cannot be wasted and we can save more trees as pollution is also increasing. So it can be to some extent, maybe the government might take a step to reduce the delivery of the newspapers in order to save the environment and the ecology.
And there will be trend of e-newspaper, you can say. Okay.
Yes,
in both ways the answer can be given. Yes. All right, this is all for today, guys. See you tomorrow.
Thank you, ma'am.